My dear students, as we have continued the topic on, the model on the probability distribution, let me consider the two important derivations. These two important for the forthcoming IA as well as the semester and examination. Okay. Therefore, let me take the simple definition of the binomial distribution. What is the definition? We shall go for it. If P is the probability of success and Q is the probability of failure, then the probability of X success out of N trials is given by P of X equal to NCX P to the power X into Q to the power N minus X, where X is given between 0 to N. And NCX is given by the result, the combination NCR equal to N factorial divided by N minus R factorial into R factorial. Is it okay? This is the basic definition of the binomial distribution. Here note that summation of P of X is always equal to 1. Yes, let me go for the derivation. The question will be given in this manner. Derive the mean and standard deviation of the binomial distribution. As I am giving the same definition or the question as we want to see, we are going to see in the forthcoming IA as well as in the semester end examination. Let me go for the mean mu. Mean is always denoted by mu. Mu is given by what? Summation between x equal to 0 to n, x into P of X. Refer this condition. And mu is given by x into, what is P of X? By the definition of the binomial distribution. What is the P of X here? This is ncx P to the power X into Q to the power N minus X. Therefore, here X is already here, and ncx is the definition of ncx using ncr. Is given by n factorial divided by n minus x factorial into x factorial, and the same terms P of X, P to the power X into Q to the power n minus x. Therefore, the exponents in the numerator, n factorial will be what? N into n minus 1 factorial divided by x factorial, can be written as x into x minus 1 factorial into n minus x factorial. P of P to the power x, we can write P into P to the power x minus 1, and the same term Q to the power n minus x. And cancellation of x with numerator denominator, the terms are showing here. Therefore, keeping n into p outside, summation is between 1 to infinity. My dear students, refer the summation of the definition of the summation. Because in the earlier step, we have taken between x equal to 0 to n. Here we are taking x equal to 1 to n. Because x minus 1 factorial is given here. Because you just observe that if I put x equal to 0, what happens? It will be 0 minus 1 factorial. I mean minus 1 factorial. Please try to note that minus factorial is always meaningless. Therefore, we are taking from between x equal to 1 to n. Yes, the right side term will be n minus 1 factorial divided by x minus 1 factorial. N minus x, we can write n minus of x minus 1. Refer the adjustment taken in the denominator. Into p to the power x minus 1, q to the power again, n minus x as we did here. The same term we are taking n minus 1 in minus of x minus 1. Therefore, np is already here, x is between 1 to n, as we have shown in the previous step. Therefore, n minus 1 factorial divided by x minus 1 factorial, x n minus 1 into x minus 1 factorial will be what? This definition will be combined to n minus 1 c x minus 1, and the rest of terms p to the power x minus 1, q to the power n minus of x minus 1, the showing here. Refer this step, very, very important. Therefore, mu is equal to np. Np is already here. And this term is equal to what? P plus q to the power n minus 1. The definition after the summation will be p plus q to the power n minus 1. And always we note that the summation, what is p plus q? P is the summation of happenings. P is the probability of happenings. Q is the probability of not happenings. The sum of these two is always equal to 1. Therefore, mu is equal to np. Therefore, mean of the binomial distribution is np. Next, variance. Variance is given by summation is between 0 to n, x square into p of x minus mu square. Refer the definition. Refer the definition. This is given here. Therefore, this term is equal to what? The condition is x square, let me consider x square p of x, the first term in the right side. This is given by x square, we can write x into x minus 1 plus x, refer this adjustment under this square bracket, into p of x. Therefore, taking the summation and the addition of these two terms, x into x minus 1 p of x plus summation between 0 to n x into p of x, and here x equal to 0 to n x into x minus 1 the same term, p of x is what? P of x is by the definition of binomial distribution n cx p to the power x into q to the power n minus x. The same term I am putting here plus x into p of x, the second term, which will be given by x into p of x is by the mean of the derivation, which will be given by np, just we have proved. Therefore, using these two facts, we can write, yes, now it will be x equal to summation between 0 to n x into x minus 1 n factorial divided by x minus x factorial into n minus x factorial p to the power x q to the power n minus x plus np, combining continuing from the last step. Therefore here it will be given by, you just observe here, x into x minus 1, what is x factorial denominator? It will be x into x minus 1 into x minus 2 factorial. Cancellation of x into x minus the numerator, leaving behind the denominator will be x minus 2 factorial. Then n factorial will be what? N into n minus 1, n minus 2 factorial divided by n minus x factorial, no change. Here p to the power x, I can write p square into p raised to x minus 2, refer this adjustment. And q to the power n minus x, no change, plus np. Therefore, keeping the constant terms n into n minus 1 into p square from the outside of the summation, x is between 2 to n, refer this definition, because if I put x equal to 0, again as we discussed in the previous condition, negative under the summation will be under the expansion, I mean the combination will be always meaningless, hence it is between 2 to n. Therefore n minus 2 factorial, because n into n minus 1 is outside, p square is outside, x is between 2 to n, n minus 2 factorial, x minus 2 factorial, refer the adjustment, n minus x equal to n minus 2 minus of x minus 2, refer this bracketed term, square bracketed term, into factorial p square p raised to x minus 2 into q minus of q raised to n minus 2 minus of x minus 2, refer the adjustment here, because x p raised to x minus 2, I can write p raised to x minus 2, no change, q raised to n minus x, as we did in the denominator, it will be q raised to n minus 2 minus of x minus 2 plus np, no change. Therefore n into n minus 1 p square already outside, the combination of these two will be what? P plus q to the power n minus 2, refer this definition of the probability distribution as we did earlier in the earlier case, plus np. Therefore after the adjustment, that is p plus q is equal to 1, x square p of x equal to n into n minus 1 p square plus np, because p plus q is equal to 1. Using this result in 1 along with mu is equal to np, the 1 result is already shown here. Therefore this term is equal to n square p square, opening the bracket, minus np square plus np, n minus n square p square, some adjustment after the addition, subtraction and so on, this term will be np into 1 minus p, but 1 minus p is equal to what? Always q, because p plus q is equal to 1. Therefore the variance v is equal to the adjustment after taking this some addition, subtraction and so on, variance v is equal to npq, and the standard deviation is what? It is the square root of variance, hence it is root of npq. Hence my dear students, refer the condition, by the binomial distribution mean is denoted by mu, is given by np, and the standard deviation sigma is given by root of npq. Close it.